we've got three title matches. We are going to see the Impact players, Justin Credible and Lance Storm, with Jason and Dawn Marie challenging the World Tag Team Champions.
Right.
Tommy Dreamer and Raven, who really are not on the same page. And it's funny, it's Francine who seems to be more sympathetic towards Raven and his emotional problems than Tommy.
Who in the hell is on the same page as Raven anyway?
That's a very
Just remember, Raven always gets the girl. You ever been out with him? You and I should go out with Raven one time.
No, thank you. I don't have the tolerance.
You know, you need to spend a little more time with the boys. I mean, you're always in the back, stooging stuff off, fighting stuff out. You're like a male rat or something. I don't know.
A male rat? I believe you popped me.
What?
On live television. How about Rob Van Dam defending the world television title against Sabu as former best friend and tag team partner?
Well, you know, that one to me is very interesting because one thing, Sabu, of course, very tight with Rob Van Dam, but Rob Van Dam is one of the only people who I know who can get under the skin of Sabu.
And Bill Alfonso is trapped in the middle. Will he make a decision tonight?
Bill Alfonso is in a win-win situation. You know, he's going to go with the winner.
How about for the World Heavyweight title? Mike Awesome, 6'6", 296, defends the title against the Giant Killer, Little Spike Dudley, 5'5", 155. Awesome knocks Spike's girl's teeth down her throat.
Yeah, we in the office are not happy with Mike Awesome. Of course, you know, we saw him put his hands on me. Shouldn't put your hands in the office.
One last question. You calling me a male rat? You're not trying to pick me up, are you? You're not.
Wait to see who comes out next. I'll show you who I'm trying to pick up. Say what's on your mind.
Okay, I don't like you. How's that? This should be a very interesting six-person tag team matchup.
Are you being politically correct again? We like that at the office. Don't want to offend anyone. Don't want any lawsuits, nothing like that.
Well, it's not a six-man. It's not six men competing. It's five men and a woman.
Oh, my God. You're talking about who I wanted to pick up. You're looking at her.
Danny Doring and the angry Amish chicken plucker Roadkill come to the ring with Elektra.
Elektra's a little overdressed for the occasion, I think.
Yeah, I don't like those feathers.
I don't like the spandex. Doring looks to be in fabulous shape, better than even usual. Now, he's usually in great shape.
You'll never see Doring running again.
Can we pan down to the upskirt cam, please?
You mean Jim Quigley from ECWWrestling.com?
The pre-bird.
Yeah, you can bet he's right underneath her.
If you look in the dictionary, next to the word tremendous, there'd be a picture of Elektra.
I don't know if these three can function as a team.
Simon and Mitch seem unaffected by her.
You think they can resist her womanly charms?
Simon is a master of controlling himself, you know that.
And here come their opponents, the team of Nova, Kid Cash, and Jazz. It should be noted that Kid Cash Friday night in Atlanta, Georgia, had his
one. He's got a jaw full of marbles. It's swollen up so much. You know, you gotta give the kid a lot of credit trying to make a big name for himself. Comes out here wrestling with a broken jaw.
Oh, Paulie wanted to pull him off the pay-per-view, and he wouldn't hear of it. He would not hear of it.
Well, you know, we in the office made him sign a release because, you know, all you got to do, if I were wrestling, if I was his opponent, I'd just reach out and tap him one time and match the over. You ever had a broken jaw, Joey? I'd like to see you get your jaw wired shut one time.
Or wire your jaw shut. Be your best work yet.
Your jaw ever get sore, stooging everyone off in the office?
My back hurts already from carrying you for the last 25 minutes.
Nova may have chosen badly here in terms of partners.